So I think it's about time that I discuss the one movie that saved cinemas in 2021, and that is Free Guy. Best video game movie ever, best one I've ever seen of the year, and I'm just kidding. Let's just talk about Peter Parker already. So I have some mixed reviews when it came to this movie. I found it pretty good when it came to fights and cameos, and personally, I liked seeing all the villains come in. But my favorite part of the movie was when Dr. Octopus got a change of heart, but then at the end it looks like he's going to help Electro kill Tom Holland. Then, Uno reverse card, he pins Electro down, well, pins him in the air, I guess, and helps the Spider-Mans defeat Electro. I also love how Norman Osborn acts, as it shows he really isn't a bad guy. He's just possessed. But then when he destroys the mask, an hour later, without the mask due to an incident, he becomes Hobgoblin. It's a really neat transition. Also, it seems everyone who tells a Peter Parker, with great power comes great responsibility, dies. Aunt May's death is something I was not expecting. Alright, that's literally all I liked about the movie. Now for the things I really hated. I would be lying if I didn't rate this a 5 out of 10, and here's why. First off, the villains. Now don't get me wrong, the villains played by the same actors was exceptional. It's just two things didn't really make sense. One, why is Sandman acting like a villain if he stopped his villainous ways? And two, why did Vulture not escape prison yet? Those questions will never be answered. Unless you guys tell me in the comments. The villains I really wanted though was perhaps put Kingpin, Rhino, or at least add Venom from Spider-Man 3. I was a little mad they didn't put him in that. Now remember, I'm talking about Venom from Spider-Man 3, not the Venom movies. But come on, let's admit it. It would have been the coolest thing for Spider-Man Venom and movie Venom to get in a huge fight with each other at some point. Or they could have just added villains that weren't from the movies yet, such as Kraven the Hunter, who we see in the Multiverse Rift. And yet, the worst villain of them all is Doctor Strange. Turn the notifications on and subscribe, so you don't miss that theory when I post it. I also found it really strange how Electro came into this movie, and yet he never met Peter Parker. But MatPat made a theory on that, and they cleared the whole thing up. This last point isn't a complaint, but I just love hearing Lizard with a British accent. Now, that may be how he spoke in The Amazing Spider-Man, but I didn't know if he talked in it. Because it's been, like, it hasn't been a decade, but it's been like at least 6 years since I've seen The Amazing Spider-Man. I just want to say the plot was terrible for half the time, in my opinion. So it starts off where it left off, and okay, that's good. The police is hunting him for this. Yeah, classic terrible cops. Then Peter goes to Doctor Strange without his girlfriend, parents, and friends' permission to turn back time. Is completely delusional, and then the spell doesn't do anything for most of the entire film. Alright, we got some problems here. First off, Peter is such an idiot in the Sanctum Sanctorum. He doesn't tell the people closest to him that he will turn back time, and he messes up a spell because he wasn't prepared. The biggest problem here, for my opinion though, is on the fight on the bridge. The cops ignore him. Everyone still knows everything they saw in Mysterio's video, and they just act like nothing happened, even though the spell didn't happen yet. It didn't make any sense for everyone to act like this if nothing changed. Also, Doctor Strange tried to send all the villains back, but Peter will not allow it. Even though throughout the entire movie, Peter didn't change any of the villains' personalities at all, except maybe Otto. So the entire sequence of Peter trying to steal the box from Strange is completely useless. Also, Peter should have not been able to defeat Strange. I honestly want Strange to ban Peter or keep the box. But no, we had to let Peter, the idiot of the situation, to keep the box. Also, when Aunt May gets killed, the explosion doesn't even hit her. So she dies from what? Speaking of Aunt May, when she's trying to inject Osborn with a serum, she doesn't for some reason. And she had so many chances to do so. That entire sequence makes no sense and solves literally nothing. And can we just address how when Ned opens the portals to the other Spider-Man's worlds, he is able to close the portals, but at the end fight, he can't? That part just doesn't make any sense at all. All right, now for the part that I hated the most. This ending sucked. I have so many problems with this ending, so grab a seat and snack if you aren't already. First off, why did they bring the box with a spell in it to the battle? Just give it to Strange. Oh wait, Peter locked him in the mirror realm. Well done, Peter. One other thing about this is Strange says he can control the mirror dimension, so why couldn't he just use that to trap Peter? Whatever. Second, if Peter were to kill Osborn, why'd he not just activate instant kill or any of his other abilities throughout the entire web-slinging movie? The last thing I have a huge problem with is how they ended the whole entire thing. Peter gets teleported to a new timeline, which makes no sense when he wishes no one remembers Peter Parker, and yet he needs to have a license, credit, and more in order to own an apartment and be in school and do the MIT. Also, he is still Spider-Man, and nobody knows it's him. Did you know there was a way they could have avoided this entire ending? In the comics, he was holding Mary Jane, they traveled throughout time together. So, if he would have just held hands with them all, they could have traveled with him, or Peter, you didn't mess up the spell, or, if Strange wasn't a villain or just an idiot, or, the entire town of Manhattan wasn't so stupid when they heard this about Spider-Man. I mean, all he did for them, and yet they hear his identity from a villain, and they're all like, oh yeah, there isn't anything wrong here. There's definitely no other side to this story. Maybe the next Spider-Man movie will be better. So thank you, Disney, for giving me this bad review. And that is why I feel like it is one of the worst Marvel movies ever made. Now, I can probably see that a lot of you really didn't like my review, but that's just my opinion. I just think they could have worked a little more on it. Anyway, see you guys next time. Be on the lookout for the Doctor Strange theory.
We are Venom.